Hi everyone, in this video we will learn about steganography through Python. Steganography is the science of hiding information by embedding a hidden message within an object. Steganography relies on deception. The object may be easily viewable, however the hidden message within may not be obvious. The object can be physical, such as a message with lemon juice on paper that is revealed when heat is applied to the paper. The object can also be electronic. In our example, we will conceal a message within a portable network graphics or PNG image using the Python programming language. Steganography and cryptography are similar yet different disciplines. Both attempt to conceal information. The difference is cryptography is stored to keep outside users away from the information. Steganography hides the message in plain sight. The hidden message does not attract attention to itself as an object of scrutiny. Before we get into the tutorial, let's review the packages that we will use. These include matplotlib, pillow, and numpy. Let us import these modules by running the first cell. Next, I am going to drag and drop the image that we are going to hide the message in into the content directory. You can access the image I am using through the GitHub repository linked in the description below. This tutorial will review how to embed a hidden message within an image. The image type that is used to embed the image is a key consideration. Two popular image types are Joint Photographic Experts Group, or JPEG, and Portable Network Graphics Files, or PNG files. Because JPEGs use a lossy compression, the file type cannot be used for steganography, because the compression deletes data. This can cause the hidden message to be deleted inadvertently. We will use a PNG image to embed the message into the image because the PNG file type uses lossless compression when it is written. This means that our data will be intact after we write our message into the image. Let us get into the code. First, I am going to use matplotlib to read in our image into a NumPy array. Then I am going to print out the dimensions of our image. This will give us the height of our image in pixels and the width of our image in pixels. I am also going to print out the channels of the image. Because this is a PNG file, there are four channels: red, green, blue, and alpha. The alpha channel stands for transparency. I am going to call on matplotlib again. This time I am going to display our image so we can take a look at it. We have an image of a Boston Terrier standing in a field. We can see on the X and Y axis we have values. These are for the number of pixels within the image. Now that we have our image loaded in and we have some data on the image, I am going to start writing our function, which will write a hidden message into our image. I am going to name my function stegwrite, and it is going to take in four parameters. The first parameter is going to be the image path, which is the location of the image on your computer. The next is going to be the message that you are looking to hide within the image. Next, we have the output path. By default, I'll set that to editedImage.png. Then finally, we have spacing, which is set to 10. I'll discuss that more later in the video. First, I am going to check that our image path is a PNG file, and if it is not, then the function will raise an error and let the user know that the input must be a PNG file. After the function has confirmed that we have a PNG file, then it will read in the image using the pillow image module, and then it will read in the image into a NumPy array. Next, I am going to take all of the ASCII string characters in our message and use list comprehension to convert all of them into integers using the ORD function. We will replace the pixel values with the values that we just calculated here to embed our message. I am going to create a variable called ImageShape, and we are going to take our pixel array and save the shape of our image. If we were to check the shape of the pixel array, we would find it is a three-dimensional shape. The first value is the height of the array in pixels, the second value is the width of the array in pixels, and the third value is the number of channels. I am going to take the three-dimensional array, flatten it into a one-dimensional NumPy array, and then convert the NumPy array to a Python list. In this segment, I am going to check that we have enough pixels to encode our message into the image. The way that I do this is I get the length of the message, multiply it by the spacing, and I compare that to the number of pixels in our flattened pixel list. If the message is longer than the number of pixels, then a value error will be provided to the user. Next, I am going to create a variable called idxList, which will save the index positions where the message will be hidden. I will take values based on the range of the length of our hidden message. I will multiply the values from the range by our spacing variable, which by default is 10. This will spread out our message within the pixels of the image. Now that I have all of the index positions where I will replace the pixel values, I am going to iterate over all of the message values within our hidden message and replace them within our pixel list using indexing. After we have replaced the pixels with our hidden message, I am going to create a new variable called editedArray, and I am going to take our pixel list, convert it to a NumPy array, then reshape it back to the original shape of the image. With our edited array, we can now pass it into the image module from Pillow and call fromArray, which will convert the array into an image. I can then save the image by giving it the output path to save it to. The Python function I created does not have to return any objects because I already saved the edited image to a given path. I will print out the message length as well as a message that the image was saved. I can now run the cell. I will now call stegwrite. For the image path, I will set it as dog_picture.png. For the output path, I will set it as edited_image.png. And for my message, I will simply put in hello. We have successfully edited the image with our message. I am now going to display the image using matplotlib. Here we have a side-by-side comparison of the edited image against the original image. Visually, we cannot see any difference between the edited image and the original image. Even if we ran algorithms or neural networks to try to find if there's any pattern, given how small the message is, it would most likely be very hard to find out that there is a message within the image. This would make it a successful case of steganography. Now we have to write a Python function to decode the message within the image. I am going to name the function stegread. It is going to take three inputs. First, we need the image path to the image with the encoded message. Next, we also need to provide the message length. If we don't have the message length, we cannot decode the message. I also need to know the spacing for the pixels in order to decode the message. I am going to create a variable called img, and I am going to call on the pillow module again and use image.open for our image path, and I am going to take the image and read it into a NumPy array. Like we did in our stegwrite function, I am going to create a pixel list where I take the pixel array and flatten it into a one-dimensional array, and I convert it into a Python list. To retrieve the index position of the hidden message characters, I am going to use list comprehension, and like before, I am going to get the range of the message length and multiply it by the index position multiplied by the spacing variable. Now that I know where the values are hidden within the pixels, I am going to take the index positions and use list comprehension on the pixel list to get the hidden values. The values are currently integers. What I need to do is call the built-in CHR function to convert it from an integer into a string character. I have all the characters saved as string values within a list. What I can do is call an empty string, call on join, and bring in all the characters together into a single string and return the string. Now that I have stegread defined, I am going to try to decode the edited image. I'm going to call stegread, input the image path, and give it a message length of 5. By default, the spacing is 10, so I will leave that as is. We have successfully decoded the image, and we can see that the message is hello. This has been an example of an application of steganography. We have an edited image that does not look different from the original, meaning if it were just posted on a website somewhere, most likely no one would ever know that it has a hidden message. And for whoever does know the hidden message, they would have the key and would be able to successfully decrypt the image in order to get the message. There are limits to the stegwrite function that we just went over. The stegwrite function within this notebook is a simple algorithm to hide a given message within the image. There are limitations. If the length of the message is significantly long enough, the pixels in the image can change enough for someone to notice the difference. Changing the spacing parameter may hide the message better, but a more sophisticated algorithm that would match the hidden message values to similar pixel values is a better solution. If the message is too long, then the number of pixels replaced in the image will render it completely different from the original. There can also be a situation where the contents of a file being written to an image are larger than the image itself, rendering steganography impractical. I will go through an example of each of these within the notebook. In the first example, we will see how a message that is fairly long can leave a visual clue. The text below is a short story, The Pit and the Pendulum by Edgar Allan Poe. We will see if we use the default spacing value, there is a visual clue that there is information embedded within the image. The spacing can be modified to better hide the information visually. Let us run the cell. I am going to write the pit and the pendulum using the stegwrite function. For the image path, it is going to be the dogpicture.png again. The message is going to be long_text1, and the output path I will set as long_image1. Now that we have our edited image written, let us display it and inspect the image. We can zoom into the image to get a closer look. At the top, we can see very subtle but noticeable blue lines. This is clearly a pattern, and somebody that is investigating the image can probably discern that there's something hidden within the image, and could potentially even break the code. I am going to attempt to write the text again to the image using stegwrite. This time, instead of using a spacing of 10, I am going to change it to use a spacing of 1. I am going to display the image using matplotlib. We can zoom into the top of the image again to see if there are any visual clues, and it looks like changing the spacing actually helped get rid of the blue lines. This shows us for longer text, you may have to play with the parameters in order to hide any potential visual clues. I am also going to attempt to decode the message using stegread. We were able to successfully decode the message, and we have the pit and the pendulum printed here. Next, we will take a look at an issue where a message is too large for an image. The text below is from one of the longest books written, The History of the Decline and Fall of the Roman Empire by Edward Gibbon. I have the text saved within a text file, and I am going to drag and drop the text file into the content directory. The text file is available in the GitHub repository in the link in the description below. I am going to write a code block where I am going to read in the text file into a Python string, and I am also going to take a look at the length of the pixels within the dog picture. Reading the text file into a Python string, the length of the string is over 9 million characters, while our image is only around 7 million pixels. Let us try to write the text to our image using stegwrite. If we try to write the text to the image, we receive a value error. And this is the value error we created earlier within our function, telling us that the number of characters is greater than the number of pixels in our image. The final issue we will look at is when the number of characters within the text is equal to or almost equal to the number of pixels in the image. Even if the number of characters in our message is not larger than the number of pixels, if there are enough characters, this can change the original image enough where it is clear that there has been an edit. In the code block below, we will take the text from declineandfall.txt and cut it down to the total number of pixels in the image. We have to set the spacing parameter equal to 1, otherwise there will not be enough pixels to swap with the characters in our message. We can display the edited image with matplotlib. We can see that we completely overwrote our original image with our hidden message, and this is an unsuccessful application of steganography. As in the previous example, to resolve this issue, a picture comprised of a larger amount of pixels can be used, or multiple pictures can be used to embed the message. Thanks everyone for watching. I hope that this video was helpful. If you want to learn more about steganography, I included additional resources within the notebook that you can check out. If you liked the video, feel free to subscribe. You can also connect with me on LinkedIn, X, GitHub, Medium, and Odyssey. Thanks again, everyone, and happy coding.